It's on right here.
Okay.
Well, I'll say it for the beginning is that I.
Are we on?
We're on.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. No. I'll let you go.
All right. Welcome. This is Casey Miller coming to you from Southwest Institute of Healing Arts. This is our 28th day of National Life Coaching Month, and today may be one of our most important coaching sessions. So thank you so much for joining us. Today we're going to be coaching around the need for approval, and we're going to be using a really great tool called What If. So Mike, thank you so much for being my guest today.
Yes.
And what is it that you might want to say to those watching and just to set the intention for the session?
So for those of you watching, coming into this, knowing for myself that this is it's quite vulnerable, and some resistance that I've been having to it, and that really the intention for this session is to just for me is to keep moving forward, because for those of you who've been tuning in, I did a coaching session with Sharon Rose, and it brought up a lot. I had the infamous shame over, which I know KC got to watch that video as well.
Shame over. What is a shame over?
Yeah, so a shame over is something that it's not my term at all. It's Bernie Brown. If you've never heard of her, I'd highly suggest looking into her. I had learned along my journey that a shame over is you might do something vulnerable. In this instance, you know, do a live coaching session and perhaps expose maybe more of yourself than you may have wanted to in that moment. Maybe, for example, going back and watching the video and criticizing or judging things about the video, about yourself, etc., etc., and feeling kind of, the best word I can put is just bleh, just like, oh man, what did I? And learning to just work your way through that the best that you can and be with that as you can. But my intention for the session is really to keep moving forward from here. And it created many. I feel like many Sweet High-ends are familiar with just that, creating that healing, creating that, or not creating healing, but going through your journeys, going through your own healing process. And I've continued to go with this healing process, and I feel like this is the next step. So yeah.
So thank you for that bravery. Yeah. So as a coach, I always want to make sure you know that you can be as vulnerable as you want, or you can say stop.
Okay.
So this is what stop looks like. Stop. Like, I don't want to go there.
Okay.
And for those of you that live life, sometimes we just have to learn to say stop, right? So this is the piece. I did watch your session with Sharon Rose, and I did watch your other sessions. And this is what I want to ask you, Mike. Help me understand what the fear is when people are on the verge of their dreams, like you see it, you know it, and what is this thing about approval? Like, what's that about?
Yeah, so matter of fact, I had just mentioned it briefly before we began, is resistance is the biggest word that comes to mind, but it's the best way I could describe it from my experiences. It's like seeing or visualizing yourself being that person that you've always wanted to be, or maybe that you didn't know you could be, but this picture starts to paint itself and it starts to become more clear. And you might be in a spot in your life or a position in your life where you're like, I've just had it. I've had it with all these things. I know I'm better than this. I know I'm greater than this. And that fear of a big thing around is that fear that I'm not living up to others' expectations. I'm not perhaps satisfying others' expectations.
And so this is what you said, and yeah. There was a part of me that was like, oh, if I could just have 30 minutes with Mike. Oh, and I want just to imagine that those of you that are watching, you may be Mike. You may have this thought that, oh, if I could just have so-and-so's approval, if I could just have so-and-so's approval. I have a gigantic story in my life about that that I won't go into right now, because this is what I want to ask. Let's just think that of one person whose approval you think or thought you might need. Can you think of one person? We're just going to call that person A.
Yes, I can.
Okay, yeah. So you have a person.
I have a person.
All right, so A. So imagine that A is right here and they are not approving of you.
Okay.
Like, can you imagine that?
I even looked at their hand as though their face is on the hand.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so what if their job in this lifetime is not to approve of you? Like, imagine that A came into this lifetime for a reason. They were going to meet you, and their whole job is not to approve of you.
That's an interesting
thought. It is an interesting thought. But what if, like, their job is, I'm here not to approve of Mike? How well is A doing their job?
Really well. And the thought that comes to mind as well is that, is if anything, that they might be doing their job so well that it's, without that person, how would I have ever come as far as I've come? Like, I have that thought as well. Yeah.
Yeah, like, that gives me goosebumps. Like, okay, so what if A is doing such a good job and that A's job is to not have approval? What would that do to you now thinking of that what if? Like, A is not approving of me, therefore...
Therefore, I feel the need to laugh about it a little because it's I find it, it's kind of goofy. It's kind of like, funny if you do put it in that perspective and that they can, I just keep kind of coming back to that. Well, wow, it's funny, but it's pushed me so far. It's pushed me out of my comfort zone more than looking back, who else or what else could have done that in my life. Yeah.
Well, who else or what else could have done that? So they are serving a purpose.
Yeah.
So put that right there because it's funny.
Yeah.
Okay. So now imagine this. What if you get these divine downloads and like they are things that only you can do? Would that be a possibility that like, whew, Mike, you have this idea. You are supposed to do that. Could you ever imagine that to be true?
I do fantasize about that, yeah.
Okay. So let's just pretend it's true, just for now.
Yeah.
That, like, when you think of them coming down, would that be from source, from the great mystery, from, like, do you have a thought of where that might come from?
I mean, for me, that's really just, I guess, I look at it as we are all people who are part of the Sweetheart community, or even if you're not, that really each and every person that has a trade is, they're an artist in some way, shape, or form. You are an artist, and the way I've looked at it is like it's that's my creativity, and when I find myself in that in flow or just allowing things to happen, that's really when those ideas come. That's really when I fantasize about those things often.
So I love the word fantasize. So you're fantasizing.
Yeah.
So let's imagine that there's the great artist in the universe, and that artist says, oh my gosh, I have these amazing ideas. I'm going to give them to Mike, and they're going to come out through his artistic expression.
Yeah.
Okay. So you can imagine that happening.
I can, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So imagine that this is what your reaction is. No, I'm not going to do it for you. No, I don't want those ideas. Like, just try that. Like, just send those ideas away.
I don't want to do that because I like it. It's it's inspiring.
So breathe into the difference of imagine that you're getting these divine inspirations. Would you call that what you're doing?
Yeah.
Divine inspirations. And every time you get a divine inspiration, you say, no, I'm not willing to show up. I'm not willing to do this. I'm not willing because...
It feels like I can already feel it because I've I think I have experienced this before where it's like it's kind of like for whatever reason if somebody has a stick and they're just poking you and poking you and poking you and saying just do it already and like and having that fear, having the what ifs come up. Actually, that is so perfect. You know, what if I'm not this, or what if I can't do this, or what if, once again, it doesn't look maybe the way they, from that person's approval, it doesn't look like this for them, or what if it doesn't look like this for me, or just all of these things. Yeah.
So I'm going to stop for just a moment, and those of you that are watching, Have you ever had those what if moments where you know that you're getting these downloads, what if, and you begin to really go into, well, what if I'm not good enough? What if? If you've ever had that experience, say yes on that. So this is an interesting thing. You were saying that you really do get into the what ifs.
Yeah, actually.
Wow.
I guess I didn't realize it until you said it, but I do give in to them. I do. It's kind of like a battle in my head of like, well, no, just let that go, but then it can come back up. And trying to be vulnerable, trying to step up into this position, to do what I know I can do, and having that feeling in my gut of just like, of butterflies, but then not knowing, I guess, if it's fear or if it's just vulnerability or yeah.
So that's an interesting thing. So I just want to acknowledge that here I am as a coach. I have this thought about where I want our coaching session to go.
Okay.
And it's like, whoop, we just span to another thing. So I think it's like, okay, I need to center myself and go with where you're going. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for that teaching.
Okay.
What if? You were just saying that sometimes you wonder if that is fear that you're feeling.
Yeah.
What if it's adrenaline? So this is an interesting thing.
Yeah.
Is it possible? What if fear and adrenaline are the exact same thing?
Yeah.
Do you know the definition of adrenaline?
I don't, but I don't know. Yeah.
It's a forward momentum chemical. Like when you experience, and you might experience it in fear, what is it you could do with that fear, knowing full well that it's actually adrenaline, a forward momentum chemical?
I could, I could continue to get out of my comfort zone is what it is. Matter of fact, for those of you who know Enyata, go ahead and just please give this video a like, because Enyata is amazing. But I was just showing Enyata prior to this in the bookstore, one of my favorite artists, and what he, something he does is he makes music, but he makes he just does it live. It's all improv. It's all just off the top of the head, and it's so inspiring to me, because that's what you're saying. It's very much just this. It's very much just go for it and not. And I feel I guess I have those I have self-doubts that hold me back from doing that. I think.
So talk about the self-doubts. Like, really, where do the self-doubts come from? Are they from A, B, C, D, all of those people of approval? Is that where the self-doubt is, or where is the self-doubt?
I think that it's, I know that it's, yeah, it's in here. It's not A. A is, matter of fact, if I look at it with, whereas A is just here to kind of, yeah, just that. They're just doing their thing. They're just doing that. And then the self-doubt is from within me. It's I think my perception of, yeah, I, there's more to that, but I think right now it's within me. Yeah.
And you already did it. Like, there's the self-doubt. You literally stopped breathing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you saw that.
I saw.
I had that. Yeah.
So realize that fear, self-doubt is a, and you have the ability to do a forward momentum activity, a big breath. So like, just take a deep breath and.
that was a big one.
That was a big one. So here's where freeze is. So I might do this. Take a deep breath and tell me where your focus goes when you do exhale in a forceful way.
Well, it goes out.
There it goes out.
Yeah, it doesn't.
Did you see it?
Yeah.
Like, that is one of the biggest things that we have to realize, is we're in this place. Either we're fearing judgment or fearing ourselves. And what is it that you've just discovered that you can do with all of that fear?
Well, it seems so simple, but it's, I guess, but like profound in the simplicity of it, that it's that I can move that out. I can move that in the forward direction. I can, that it's okay to be afraid because I'm just, if I'm in this forward motion, if I'm in this, that, because I've had this experience working at the job that I do where it very much involves public speaking, and was afraid when I got the job initially that speaking in front of crowds of people, especially with children involved in it, that I would like just totally bomb and totally fail. And hearing myself say that, you know, totally fail, like I haven't, and I've gotten a lot better at speaking in front of groups of people, and especially when the situation is just totally out of control, and I'm like, well, I don't know what to do here, but that I've experienced that firsthand, that it's when I'm afraid, if I just push through, I might make hiccups along the way, but that I can just keep going, and ultimately, it's okay, because I know I'm not going to see that. I may not see that person again in my life. So it's like, well, okay, you know, I made the mistake, and now I've learned and I've gotten better at it. So, yeah.
So you're ready to step forward in your business. Thank you. Thank you for that. Yeah. Like, maybe you're not. Let me just say this.
No.
What if you're not ready to step forward in your business? Could you breathe into, I'm not ready to step forward in my business?
See, that's the thing. I don't want to, but just but I feel like I could not just answer that honestly just now. Like, that I would be lying to you if I answered yes, I am, because I feel that resistance in myself.
Beautiful.
And that's, I know I want to. I'm
but
done.
Just be honest and say,
yeah.
You know, like, what if I want to, I'm not ready today. Like, what does that do in the truth of your knowingness?
That brings the thought that that it's okay to be where I'm at. It's okay. It's that I know that I'm putting in the work behind the scenes, and that, yes, that it makes me feel like credit, you know, like credit is due where it's like I'm getting approval. That's what that feels like. Because I've been doing a lot of things that people haven't seen. A lot of behind the work stuff. And it does actually give me approval in a way. Approval to be like nice to myself and just kind of like, okay, it's okay. I'm not where I see others where they're at and where I would like to be. Which is really, really nice, actually, because having that feeling of like, well, I need to be here, I need this to be done, I need, I want, and like I can breathe, actually, saying that.
So that's a beautiful place. I mean, sometimes maybe coaches push too hard, or maybe they set up their own expectations. So obviously I had a whole thought of what this session was going to be, and I'm breathing into, wow, what if Mike is allowed to just be where he is? And it's not about facing A, and it's not about breathing into the future. What would it be about? What if?
You're reminding me to breathe. I'm forgetting to breathe, actually. No, I'm glad you brought that up, because I did. I had this idea of, what if this session is going to be about A, and what do I need to resolve with A? What do I need to... that's... What if it's just... If it's just me? What if it's as simple as just being okay with that I don't have it yet, but that's okay, and I'm still... Yeah, that I'm just here, that I'm,
okay.
Yeah.
So some of it could be that we're just here. And those of you that are watching, if that's your case, if you breathing into, I'm not there yet, I just am going to breathe into where I am, then that's one thing. Let's just go back one moment When you now think about approval, how important is that for you?
It is. Mm-hmm. However, it's just, it's my own approval of myself is what it is. It's
there you go. Like really, like that. Say, like, get that.
Whew. I guess I didn't know how, yeah, it's, that feels a little strange to say that, but it's my, this is actually brings up something from the past session that I did, that I didn't quite find a stable point with it, but that it made me think, well, do I love myself? Do I actually care about myself? Do I show that to myself enough? And intellectually knowing that, like, I do my best to do that. That I feel like everyone does their best to really care and love for themselves. And that we might get caught up, or at least I do, I get caught up in my judgments of what I think other people think about me, but it's just me. And
so, what if this is true? What if we have people in our life that do judge us so that we have an opportunity to say, stop it? So, not that you would ever be this rude, but just use your hand for just a moment and imagine that there's someone out there that is judging you. Just go with me. It's like, give them a, like, stop it. Stop it. And I'm sure that there are some of you that have somebody that you just want to say, stop it.
Yeah.
Okay. Would you do this?
Yeah.
Stop it.
Oh, wow. Okay, let's take a breath. No, that's, wow. Well, because what I was seeing, too, is, once again, when you're doing this, I see A on your hand.
Yeah.
And then so I'm thinking, well, A, stop it. And then now A is looking at me and saying, stop it. You know, stop. Wow.
Wow.
Yeah, wow. And that changes everything, though, because that's like, that's putting the ball back in my court, in your own court, and yeah.
So this is what I do believe. I believe in our lifetime, we will always have someone that we think we need their approval from. And you just said it, in the end, it's our approval. Yeah, yeah.
I'm still having a hard time breathing through that, but it's, it is. It's that's where I'm at with this today. Yeah. I'm not,
Do you think it's important at all that you know that you could say to someone, like, stop it, or thank you for doing your job well? You've disapproved of me beautifully.
I've never thought of it like that.
So let me just tell you a little tiny story. Do you happen to know the author named Wayne Dyer?
I do, yeah.
Okay. So there was a time in my life that I thought that Wayne Dyer's approval meant more than my father's approval, my husband's approval, God's approval. Like, can you imagine that being that Wayne Dyer was my big one? Okay.
Yeah.
So have you ever heard of this weird little thing called toe reading?
Have, yes, actually.
And it's a coaching technique, right?
Yeah.
So imagine that you have a chance to go and meet Wayne Dyer, and you have this thought that you're going to get to read his toes. Would you have any sense of how your body would be?
I would be a little afraid, yeah.
Wayne Dyer, and you're going to go. All right, so imagine that you walk in, and that as you walk in, Wayne Dyer is telling someone that Casey Miller, she's a kook. And that she just made that stuff up. Okay, so I walk in thinking I'm going to have a chance for approval from somebody that I consider.
Yeah.
What would your experience be?
I feel like I would be very similar to yours. I would be afraid. I would be, what if Wayne thinks this? What if Wayne does think I'm a kook? What if Wayne thinks that I'm, wow.
Wow.
Wow, yeah, that's that would be hard.
It would be hard, and this is what I am so thankful I did.
Yeah.
I stopped right there and I did this. And I began to laugh. And I walked out the door and walked right behind, like, here's the door, and I'm like this, standing like this. And I begin to laugh, and I look up, and I say, thank you, teacher. What did I learn?
That it's not, wow, and it's not even through, like, our mentors or our the people that we aspire to. It's just through us. It's our own, just caring about having our own approval is the short
answer. It was amazing. Yeah. It was like I walked out and I said, thank you for allowing Wayne not to approve of me or what I did, for allowing a man that I thought was, oh, if I could just call me a kook.
Yeah.
In a loving way.
Yeah. And that brings up, it brings up a lot because, like, being a part of the millennial generation, having a lot of, so I consider a lot of the people that I look up, I love YouTube, and there's a lot of people that have been mentors in a way to me on YouTube. Really, I just seek out, you know, this need to understand, this need to try to understand it all. And so people like Wayne Dyer, Bernie Brown, his name is, I think I'm pronouncing this right, Sadhguru, and Jay Krishnamurti, and like all of these different people, and having that in my head of like, well, I wonder what they would think of me, of like where I'm at with all of this, or
they're right here and they're watching one of your videos right now, Mike.
Yeah,
like,
and
they
and
are watching one of your
and
videos
that's what
right
I,
now
I think about that and I'm like, but what would they think of my message? They might think
what
I'm
would they
okay.
think of your message. And this is the question: can you breathe into my message is my message, and this divine inspiration has been given to me to creatively express their way?
My way, my yeah. way. Wow. That's where a lot of the judgment is coming from. I just realized that because I just want to, I guess you could relate. It's that feeling of like you love Wayne Dyer.
Wayne
is amazing, and you love their stuff, and you're like, wow, this is amazing.
Yeah.
I wonder what they would think of my work. I wonder.
And so I went begging, and his disapproval wasn't really about my work. It was about he had a friend, and he wanted to make sure she wasn't being taken in by this promoter.
Okay. Yeah.
But it was the best thing that ever happened because I was able to realize that was the invitation I needed. I needed that disapproval so I could approve of myself. Now later, I had a chance to have him have a Torah reading, and then from the stage, he said, how about those Torah readings?
Isn't it funny how that works?
So it's not about him. Yeah. It was about me getting really clear. I needed his disapproval. So imagine right now that every time someone in your current thought disapproves of you, what is that an invitation for?
An invitation to, or an invitation for me to say thank you. Thank you for disapproving of me so that I can approve of myself.
Yes!
Wow.
Thank you for disapproving of me so I can approve of myself. Now,
that feels so, I just want to say that feels so like counterintuitive, but it's not, but like it's,
This is what I believe. We're given really important work to see if we're spiritually reliable.
Yeah, because it's made me show up in ways that I never thought I could, or,
And so after a while, if you are not spiritually reliable, that divine source will say, let's just pass right on by him and give it to somebody else. Do you know that that happens?
I didn't know.
Think about it. Have you ever had an idea and you were going to do it and you're going to do it and you didn't and someone else did it?
I wouldn't say me, but I've witnessed that. Yeah, absolutely.
So imagine that that is the way the universe works. And this divine creative source says, oh, I'm pretty sure this is Mike's idea. And Mike's like, nah.
See, that's See, I didn't look at it as like pushing it like that, but yeah, now when we put it in terms of like, well, I'm just ignoring you, like, it makes me want to change that a lot quicker, because.
So every time you get this down into this download that you're going to do a video or you're going to do a meditation,
yeah.
And I just want you to do this.
And stop it.
What? Yes, it's ridiculous, right?
It's funny.
Yeah. And what if you do this? Bring it on. Like, count on me.
Yeah, wow. That's so stop it, count on me. Yeah.
Stop it, count on me. So imagine how many people 27 years ago thought that Sweetheart was a kooky idea.
Probably a lot, but like, yeah. But to see what it has manifested into is amazing.
So I could have said, oh, like, don't give me those ideas. No. Okay. Like, use me. And that's now my prayer. Like, every day, it's like, use me. Imagine that began to be your prayer.
Use me.
Huh? Use me. Rely on me.
That's
trust me.
Trust me, yeah.
I will not stay in my fear.
I will not stay in my fear. Trust me, rely on me, use me. Yeah. Use me, wow. Yeah.
So those of you that are watching, imagine that your prayer began to be, rely on me, trust me, use me. Versus, oh no, don't give me any more ideas. Oh no, don't give me any more clients. What if clients are just waiting for you and you're saying, no.
It hurts a little because thinking back to myself where I was out in my journey and wanting somebody now like myself to be there and to be open, to be willing, to be just somebody to listen, and to potentially help. Yeah.
So this is a big deep. This is a big question I'd like you to breathe into as we end this session.
Okay.
Are you ready? Be in your truth. Don't say anything that's not true to you.
I'm ready, yes.
Is it I'm ready or I will be ready?
I'm ready, and today I may not be where I would like to be, and I'm ready to step into this. I'm ready to step into being open, being reliable, so that others along their journey may be able in some way or another, and I know I can't heal people, but that I can just be there for them and hold a space for them. Yeah.
So what's your biggest takeaway from today? We had 30 minutes. This has been like 30 minutes.
of
what if?
Longest 30 minutes, but of what if, yeah, of what if.
What if. So what is going to be your biggest what if?
What if I showed up every day in that space of what if I'm open, what if I'm willing, what if I'm stop it and I'm here and I'm willing and I'm open. Yeah.
So thank you so much for tuning in today. I will go back and comment on any of your comments. What if this was the day that you let go of the approval? What if this was the day that you said, oh, those divine inspirations are an invitation for me to step forward? What if what Mike did today was for you? What if every day your prayer was, use me, I'm open, I'm willing? And that's life coaching. Thank you so much for tuning in today for the 28th day of National Life Coaching Month. We appreciate the opportunity to share with you different techniques, but more importantly, to share that what one person does, we do for the greater good. Wow. Blessings. Blessings.